Yep, Victor Martinez is coming back for more as the chase for a world title continues in Detroit, something that's eluded the Tigers for 30 years. This past season ended as the previous three ended, with a division title but short of their ultimate goal. Here's a look back at how 2014 went down in Motown.
I've told most all of you in the past, when it's time, it's time. It's time to step down from the managerial position of Detroit Tigers. And from the bottom of my heart, to the fans, to the media, to this organization, thank you for having me.
Retooling of the Tigers continues to be a major offseason talking point.
Prince Fielder off to Arlington. Kinsler is off to the defending American League Central champs. Doug Fister getting sent to the Washington Nationals. They've signed All-Star closer Joe Nathan, who is 39 years old.
A lot of people have them being the class of the AL Central.
Oh, yeah. Wow.
Detroit Tigers have acquired David Price.
Detroit now has a rotation with three Cy Young winners.
Another masterpiece tonight.
The rest of the Central, they're chasing second place. They're just too good.
I know the fans sometimes make it seem like if we're not perfect, then we're not doing our job.
They have not been in sync.
I mean, it's not that easy, and we're not robots.
You don't give up that many runs and generally have a call it a good night.
I'm so disappointed in the Tigers right now.
Unbelievable. Unbelievable.
This is probably the most frustrating point in my career.
This team is better than this.
It's crazy.
This club does not look ready to play. They're still there.
They're still there.
And this is what it's all about. The Royals are facing the three-time division champs, the Detroit Tigers. They're in front of them in the standings.
Win a game! Okay, win a baseball game.
What a win for the Tigers.
Beautiful.
It's a dogfight atop the AL Central right now.
Tigers come from behind late and hang on to first.
And the Tigers hang on and make it two straight in Kansas City.
See the Tigers inch a little bit closer to a fourth consecutive division crown.
They're on their feet, 40,000 plus.
Third base, this is trouble. Down to second, one relay to first, and the Orioles eliminate the Tigers.
This is stunning.
And the Tigers in three games have been eliminated by the Baltimore Orioles.
And that Tigers team may look very different in 2015. Torrey Hunter, one of the free agents, Max Scherzer as well, Jabba Chamberlain, and Phil Koch, four of the guys, notable free agents on this Tigers club. Here we go. Let's talk Tigers now. And what will it require to get Max Scherzer back in a Tigers uniform? That's a possibility, Bill Ripken.
Well, I mean, they threw out what I thought a pretty good offer. You know, a
144
while
mil.
Is that a pretty
not
good
bad
offer? Yeah. And when you looked at that free agent board, when you think about Torrey Hunter and Max Scherzer, I mean, those are big, big pieces of the puzzle right here. I'm sure Detroit would like to get Max back, but I just think that bidding war that's going to go on for him later in the offseason, that's going to be tough to bring him back.
What do you think, Tom?
Yeah, I'm with you, Billy. I mean, I wouldn't rule it out 100%, but what would have to happen was that maybe that market doesn't develop for Scherzer. And then you'd also really, I think, you'd have to find a market for David Price in the trade market, because they brought him in knowing that Scherzer was absolutely, I mean, not absolutely, but probably leaving based on turning down that contract extension offer. So do I see it happening? No, but there is a slim scenario where you can say it might happen.
If you take Scherzer out of this starting rotation, that was a strength of this Tigers team. In fact, the Orioles thought so much of their rotation, they posted the names of the Cy Young winners that they defeated in the ALDS. But this is without Scherzer. This is a potential rotation. Price, Verlander, Sanchez, who's no slouch, Porcello, and Lobstein, who did a nice job coming up toward the end of the year. Is this a rotation that can win the Central Division?
Yes, I think that's good enough to win. Now, a lot of that depends on Verlander, who I thought looked better at the end of the season. To think that he's your absolute number one horse the way he was in Cy Young years, probably asking too much at this point. But that's absolutely good enough to win. We know the problem is more finishing games than starting them.
Yeah, that's where I was going next, Bill. The pen. This is not a secret. In fact, if people like me, morons like me, can sit at home and say the Detroit pen is a problem, everyone knows this is a problem. What do you make of it?
Yeah, and when you think about that, look, if Max is not in the starting rotation, that takes a big hit. I agree with Tom. I think that the starters can do enough, but you absolutely have to win the games when you're winning by eight. because they are going to be not as good as they were last year or the year before that. So it is an issue at the back end of the pen. They didn't close out every game like they should.
Who fits in there?
Well, listen, I know they still have money in Soria and Nathan, but I think Andrew Miller is the perfect fit for that team. I mean, he started his career there in that organization. Not that that gives them any leg up on anybody else, but in terms of a guy who can pitch at any point in a ballgame, including the ninth inning, I think you're talking about someone who's going to get close to closer's money. I mean, his AAV may be approaching 10, if not hit 10, with all the interest in him. But that being said, I think he's the perfect fit for the Tigers.
Left side of the infield, Castellanos at third, and we expect Iglesias to come back healthy in 2015. Is that doing it for you?
Iglesias could be the key to the whole thing because we saw what he was able to do. His defensive prowess is unbelievable. He's going to make Castellanos better just because he knows, Castellanos knows to his left, he's got everything covered. So I like that kid right there. I think they took a big step backward at the shortstop position when he went down and wasn't able to play. But I think Castellanos with 11 home runs, I'm looking at him, the way he can hit the ball to right center field as a right-hand hitter, I wouldn't be surprised if he's 20, 22 home runs coming up in this next season. Then everything looks a lot better on the left side of that infield.
Yeah, I like him a lot, too, what you just said, the 11 home runs at age 22. Don't forget that, everyday player at age 22. That bodes well. Really has to work on plate discipline. 11 home runs, 8 of those were on first pitches. I mean, he swung at first pitch. Basically, he left the dugout swinging the bat. I think he controls the strike zone a little bit more. You'll see him put up better numbers because he's just so young.
And that number has to improve as well. So we need more production from the third baseman, and we need a healthy shortstop for the Tigers in 2015.